Hello everyone, my name is Ashish and welcome to the X-Admin channel. This is the continuation of the last lecture on constructor, and guys, in the last lecture we discussed about the constructor and what is the need of a constructor and how we can create constructor, right? So guys, in this lecture we will discuss about the types of constructor. So guys, there are the three type of constructor in Java. The first is the default constructor, and guys, it is also called as a no argument constructor. And guys, the second is the no argument constructor, which is generated by the user. And guys, the third is like the parametric constructor. Okay, so guys, we are going to discuss about all this type of constructor one by one in a deep manner. So guys, the first is a default constructor. So guys, the default constructor are the constructor which is generated by the compiler. And guys, remember one thing, default constructor is generated by compiler, not by the JVM. Okay guys, so guys, the default constructor is generated by compiler, not by the JVM. Okay, and guys, if we don't write any default constructor in a class, then guys, compiler will generate its own constructor, and which is called as default constructor. And guys, it is of the no argument constructor, right? So guys, that type of constructor which are inserted by the compiler, if we are not writing our own constructor in a class, then that type of constructor are called as default constructor. Okay, so guys, here we can see that we have a class with a name test, and we have a public static void main method. And guys, inside the main method we have created the object of this class test with the t. And guys, the t is the reference variable or the object of this class test. So guys, as the object of this class test is created, so now guys, the compiler is going to look that if the user has defined any constructor or not. So guys, here the user had not defined any constructor. So guys, this constructor inserted by the compiler here, public test. Okay, so guys, the public test is a constructor which is inserted by the compiler. If the user is not defining any constructor by himself, then guys, compiler will insert a constructor of the no argument type, and these type of constructors are called as default constructor, right guys? So guys, the default constructor are the constructor which is generated by the compiler, not by the JVM, remember. Okay, and guys, if the user is not defining any constructor in a class, then at the time of the object creation, the compiler is going to check that whether the user is defined any constructor or not. If the user is not defined any constructor and the compiler finds that the user has not defined any constructor, then the compiler is going to insert a constructor, and this type of constructor is called as default constructor, right? So now guys, this constructor created by the compiler itself, and guys, it is called as the default constructor. Okay, and guys, this constructor is always a no argument constructor, and it will not be a parametric constructor, right guys? Inside the default constructor guys, there are the more statements like a super keyword and this keyword. So guys, we are going to discuss the super and this keyword in the next lecture. Okay, so now guys, we are going to only discuss the type of constructor, right? So guys, the compiler will create default constructor in that case if we are not creating any constructor, and then only compiler will insert a default constructor. I hope you understand what is default constructor and how the compiler insert a default constructor and why the compiler insert a default constructor if the user is not defining any constructor or writing any constructor in the class, then the compiler will insert a default constructor. Okay, so now guys, we are going to discuss about the second type of constructor, that is known as a non-argument constructor. And guys, it is a user defined constructor. So guys, here the user defined the constructor in a class is called as, this is the constructor which the user creates by himself. And now guys, we will discuss about the no argument constructor, that is the user defined constructor, and this is constructor which user creates by himself. And guys, here guys, we can see that we have a class test, and guys, inside the class test the user has defined one constructor with the test. And guys, here we can see that here is a no argument is present. So guys, it is called as no argument constructor, and guys, it is a user defined constructor, right? Because guys, user is writing this constructor as a no argument constructor. So guys, inside this we have a main method, and inside the main method we have created the object of this class. So guys, as the object is created, as we have seen in the previous lecture, as the object is created, the constructor is called. And guys, as the user is defined this class, so guys, this will invoke at the time of the object creation. So guys, here the compiler will not insert any constructor by itself, because guys, user has already defined a no argument constructor. So guys, this type of constructor which are defined by the user is called as no argument constructor, and guys, it is a user defined constructor. Okay, so now guys, we are going to see the next type of constructor, and guys, it is the parametric constructor. And guys, this is the constructor which user define by himself and with some parameters. Okay, so guys, for example, we can see that we have a class test, and inside the class test the user has created a constructor, and guys, inside the constructor it is pass a parameter with the string name. And guys, we have a main method, and inside the main method we have created the object, and inside the constructor we have passed a string Ashish. So guys, Ashish will go to this string name. So guys, as the object is created, so guys, the compiler is going to call the test constructor, and guys, it is a parametric constructor because here we are passing a parameter in a constructor, right? So that's why it is called as parametric constructor. And guys, Ashish will be get stored to name here. Okay, and guys, this type of constructor which is having like the parameter, and guys, it is defined by the user, is called as a parametric constructor. Okay, so now guys, we are going to see some the practical example of this, of the constructor, how to write constructor and how to deal with the constructor. Okay, so let's go to our IDE, and guys, here I am going to create one Java class, a new Java class, and guys, I am going to name this class as a test. Okay, so guys, inside this class I have create I am going to create a main method. Okay, so let's create one main method, public static void main, and let's pass the string args array as an argument. Okay, and now guys, inside this guys, I have created a test class, and inside the test class I have created a main method. Okay, and now guys, inside the main method I am going to create the object of this test class. So let's create the object of this test class with t1 equals to new test. Okay, so guys, here I have created the object of this class test. Okay, and now guys, as the object of this test is created, and guys, the compiler finds that there is no user defined constructor here. So guys, user is going to insert a default constructor by the compiler. And guys, let's see how we can say that the user is defining, or guys, inserting a default constructor by itself if he is not finding any user defined constructor here. So guys, for that guys, we can check that by just guys, let's write, or guys, let's create a property with the name int I. Okay, so guys here I have created a ID as a variable. Okay, ID as a variable, and now guys, what I will do, okay, and inside the main method, after the object creation, I will do a system.out.println, and now guys, I will print the ID value. Okay, and now guys, I will print the ID value, and guys, I will check the value of this ID here. Okay, so guys, we can call this by using a object of this class, so t1.id. and now guys, if this object is created, then guys, at the time the compiler will check that if any user defined constructor is present or not. So guys, here we can see that user has not defined any constructor, So guys, compiler will insert a default constructor, and guys, T1 will take some space in the memory, and guys, it will store ID there, and guys, it will initialize with the default value of the ID, and guys, add as the return type, and guys, that type of the ID is like the integer type. So guys, it is going to store the value 0 to the ID. So guys, we can print the value, and guys, if we get the output 0, then we can say that guys, the compiler has inserted a the default constructor, and guys, it is store the ID as the default value. So let's run this program and let's check the output of the same. So guys, we can see that we got the output as 0. It means that guys, compiler inserted a default constructor and it initialized the ID with its the default value. And guys, let's see, for example, let's print so let's put some more variable of a string type name. Okay, and now guys, I will print the name here. Okay, and now guys, what I will do, I will print a name here. So t1.name, and guys, compiler should initialize the name with its default value, and guys, the name type is of string type. So string default value is null, so null should be printed after 0. So let's run and see the program that whether we are getting the output. So guys, here we can see that 0 and null, so means ID is 0 and null, and guys, name is null is initialized by the compiler. Okay, so guys, in this way guys, we can see that a default constructor has been inserted by the compiler if he does not find any constructor inside a class. So guys, these type of constructors are called as a default constructor, which are inserted by the compiler. Okay, if the user does not define any constructor in a class, right guys? And now guys, we are going to see the second constructor type by our practical example. And guys, in this we are going to see the second example. And guys, the second example was the no argument constructor. And guys, for this guys, user is going to define a no argument constructor. So guys, we have a class and we have a name as ID and string name as name and ID. We have the properties, and now guys, user is going to define a no argument constructor. So no argument constructor means we have to define a constructor with a no argument. So this is our constructor, right? And guys, this is our constructor, and guys, as this object is created, it is going to call this constructor. So now guys, how we can check that if we create the object and guys, the constructor is called or not? So for that guys, let's do one thing. Let's delete this, and guys, here I am going to print a simple statement out there to see that whether this no argument constructor is called or not. So let's just write no arg constructor called. Okay, and now guys, as the object of this class is created, and guys, we know that the role of the constructor is that constructor is executed automatically at the time of the object creation. So guys, it should call this constructor automatically, and guys, it should print no argument constructor called. So let's run this program and let's see the output we are getting or not. So guys, we can see that guys, no argument constructor called is printed in our console. So guys, it means that guys, when we create an object, a constructor is call. And guys, here we are using a no argument. So guys, here the no argument constructor is called. And guys, this type of constructor which does not have any argument present, and guys, it is known as a no argument constructor, and guys, it is a user defined. It means that guys, user is defining here. Okay, so now guys, we can see a next example, or the next type is like a parametric constructor. So guys, I will change this code for the parametric constructor. So guys, the parametric constructor are the constructor which are defined by the user, and which guys, it is passing a some parameter. So guys, here I will pass a parameter like string name and also integer ID, right? So guys, here I have passed the name and the ID, and now guys, what I will do, I will initialize the name property with this name parameter, and also the ID property with this ID parameter. And guys, here I will take, let's write the message as parametric constructor. Okay, or let's write parametric. And then guys, inside this guys, I am going to print the value of ID, and so this dot ID, and let's put some space between this. And guys, after this I will print this dot name, and guys, it should print the name and the ID. And now guys, inside the main method, what we have to do, we have to create the object. And guys, we have created the object, but guys, here guys, you can see that we have now a parametric constructor. Okay, so guys, we should match the parameter of this constructor. So guys, here the name and the ID are the parameter. So guys, we have to pass the name, so let's pass Ashish, and ID as 101, right? And now guys, as the object is created, okay, and now guys, as the object is created of this class, and as we know that when the object is created, the constructor is invoked. And guys, here, and guys, here we have used the parameter constructor, and guys, we are passing a two parameters. So guys, Asis will be taken by this name, and the ID will store 101. Okay, and guys, this is the parametric constructor, and here guys, name will be stored to this name, and this dot ID means ID will be initialized with the ID value, which is 101. Now guys, after this we have system.out.println, which is going to print parametric, and after that ID value and the name value. So let's run this program, and guys, let's check that whether this is working or not. So guys, we run this program, and guys, we can see that parametric, ID 101, and Ashish. So guys, in this way guys, we can say that at the time of the object creation, our constructor get called. And guys, here if we are passing a parameter in a constructor, then guys, that type of constructor are called as parametric constructor. Okay guys, I hope you understand that what is parametric constructor, right guys? Okay guys, so guys, I hope you understand what is parametric constructor, and how we can initialize a parametric constructor, and how we can use a parametric constructor. So now guys, do you know that what are the reason of not having a return type of the constructor? So guys, as we have seen that guys, there is a no return type of the constructor, and like the not void also. So guys, the return type of the constructor the reason for that is like there is no return type of the constructor, because guys, as the main work of the constructor is to initialize the object, right guys? So guys, the main work of the constructor is to initialize the object. So guys, there is no need of the return type in this. So that's why guys, this is the first reason for that there is no return type, because the main work of the constructor is to initialize the object, not to return anything. Okay, and guys, the second reason that the there is no return type for the object is, guys, is if we are not creating our own constructor, then compiler creates its own default constructor, right guys? If we are not creating our own constructor, okay, so guys, here guys, if I remove this constructor, and if I remove this here, and guys, at the time of the object creation, the compiler is going to create a default constructor. And now guys, the compiler is going to create a default constructor, so guys, compiler cannot judge what should be the return type of it. Okay, so because guys, compiler is generating a constructor, so guys, compiler cannot judge like the return type of it will be of integer type, or it will be a string type. So that's why guys, compiler cannot judge what should be the return type of it. So that's why the second reason is that the constructor does not return anything. Okay guys, so guys, these are the two the reason that the constructor does not have any return type. So guys, I hope you understand in this lecture what are the types of the constructor. Okay, So guys, thank you for watching this lecture, and guys, in the next lecture we are going to see the what is a this and what is a super statement in constructor. So thank you and have a nice day guys. See you in the next lecture.